Thanks, Tyson.
Okay, well, Maui Police Department celebrates a one-of-a-kind accomplishment with this week's highlights from the Valley Isle. Is Jeff King from Maui TV News. Good morning, Jeff.
Good morning, you guys, and happy Aloha Friday. However, it's tragedy that leads us to our top story this week on Maui TV News. Headlines across the nation this week tell the story of a mentally ill man in Minnesota convicted of killing his mother years ago and ordered never to own a gun. However, this week, police discovered the man had an arsenal of semi-automatic weapons and shotguns. And police in Nevada are still in shock that one of their own, a lieutenant, took the lives of his son and wife before turning the gun on himself. Whether it's the burdens of society or maybe a lack of coping skills, these kinds of sad headlines are just all too frequent. Well, on Maui, police are doing something about it. It's the first of its kind in the state. Some 20 MPD officers graduated last week and now are accredited members of the MPD-CIT, the Maui Police Department Crisis Intervention Team. Of course, every call that Maui police respond to has an element of danger and unpredictability, but now training and dealing with individuals with mental challenges may result in less violence and less danger to both victims and perpetrators, not to mention police. 15-year MPD veteran Sergeant Tony Crow acknowledged that a good deal of the training focused on what might be considered common sense, but they definitely have new tools to use when coming face-to-face with an unstable situation.
A lot of it was stuff we already did, but it's more giving us the name for it and better tools on how to address them, talking to the consumers, finding out how we can better approach them when they need us.
This training was established by Dr. Dara Rampersad, a forensic coordinator of the Maui Community Health Center. The new CIT members handle incidents involving the mentally ill and those in crisis with care and expertise. Police departments across the state will be evaluating the effectiveness of the Maui program to see if it might be appropriate on the other islands as well. Also this week on Maui TV News, a 55-year-old time capsule was discovered this week on a Wailuku site that's going to be demolished. We'll show you what was inside the rusty metal box. We have those stories and more in high definition this week at MauiTVNews.com. That's it for now. For Maui TV News, I'm Jeff King. Have a great weekend.